The state's legislative session is coming to an end today, and hundreds of bills are ready for a final decision.
Dallas Hontiveros joins us live from the state capitol with all the details. Morning, Dallas.
Good morning, Christine Ross. Yep, let's see how the future looks like. And here joining us on Wake Up Today is Ron Cochi, who is a Senate president. Good morning, Senator. How are you?
Good morning. I'm great. It's the last day of session.
Yes, it must feel good. And I got to say, you are now an official Hall of Fame of people who wake up at 5 in the morning for an interview. Feels good?
Feels good.
Awesome.
Some coffee already.
Exactly. We're just talking about how that's mandatory at this time of the day. But before the sun comes up, I just want to ask you all these thoughts digesting. Today's the last day. Out of 1 to 10, 10 being the best as far as experience goes and the progress that's been done, how do you think this session went those last few months?
Well, I still give us an I, not a 1 to 10 for incomplete, because there's a lot of work that still needs to be done, but we did deliver on tax credits that are going to be easy to access so we can help the Alice community. We've delivered on the money for affordable housing. We've looked at a variety of options with a strong dollar commitment for homelessness, mental health services, the pre-K. So at this point, the I is because now that the money's there, we need to follow through and make sure that it gets deployed, units get built, the refunds get to the people who need it, and we can help those who really are still financially struggling in our community.
You know, of the issues that you mentioned, from taxes, education, homelessness, housing, and everything else that we missed out on, which one would you say is the most complicated right now, especially coming out of the pandemic, hardships like inflation still happening? What are your thoughts?
There are a couple of difficulties. One, in the commitment to the pre-K units, I think the Lieutenant Governor has done a fantastic job of identifying where we can create classrooms and more seats right away, but we need to be sure we can recruit both the teachers and the assistants so that we can staff up to have those rooms with students in them. And then to go through the planning and regulatory process of where we're going to build the affordable housing to make sure that we're checking all of the environmental boxes and getting things done. There's quite a bit of work to be done, and community meetings and reports that need to be filed, planning commissions, to review the work. And so I think those two are really going to challenge us. And then I neglected to mention at the top, there's money for teacher housing. Mm-hmm. And we have three specific sites in Mililani, Waipahu, and Nanakuli, because they're ready to go. And we're still looking for sites around the state in future years, because that's going to be critical if we're going to be able to recruit and retain teachers.
Most definitely. And I know it does take a process, but as far as all the bills that have been lined up, how soon could we see some kind of impact from what has been done so far?
Oh, I think before we get back next year. The seats for the pre-K should be available by the next school year, and some of the affordable housing, I think you'll see, where we're breaking ground, because we've identified where we have infrastructure available and shovel-ready projects.
All right. Well, sounds great. Thank you so much, Senator, for your time. We appreciate your time and really sharing all the information with us.
Thank you very much.
And we'll be out here throughout Wake Up Today and also Take Two, really just getting the overall look of what the last day looks like of the legislative session. But if you want some more detail as to everything that has been mentioned and the topics that we've covered, you can visit our website at kh12.com. Report over here at the state capitol, Dallas Hontiveros, KH12 News, working for Hawaii.
Thank you, Dallas, and thank you, Senate President. An investigation continues this morning following an attempted kidnapping near a